Welcome on to the next edition of Run with Coach Parry. I'm Brad Brown, and we've got our coach with us, Lindsey Parry. Lindsey, how's it? And welcome back.
Sure, Brad. Good to be back.
Lindsey, this is such a great question because you hear this term being thrown around all the time on various platforms, within our forum, in Facebook groups, and other forums online. And I'm talking about lactic acid, and everyone has a theory about it and how to get rid of it and what causes it. I'm going to ask you straight up, is lactic acid real or is it a myth?
So, hey, 2 weeks in a row now where I have to say it's both. Lactic acid is definitely real, and we generally measure it as blood lactate, but we know that the things that we measure in the blood are reflective of what's happening at the muscle site. So yes, there's definitely lactic acid. It's real, it's a thing, but it's a complete myth that lactic acid is what brings on the end of exercises. And in fact, what we have learned is that blood lactate, and by implication lactic acid, is cleared very quickly and is used by the body to produce energy. So after muscle glycogen, that pyruvate, which is what the blood lactate will become in the liver, forms a very important part of our body's ability to keep producing energy while we are exercising. So it's got a bad reputation, and unfortunately most of these type of things take decades for us to get rid of that, let's call it myth, for lack of a better word. Another example of that is, just so that people understand, is that we've learned now that drinking too much fluid during exercise can be fatal. Yet, still, when you go onto radio stations in the weeks leading up to marathons and ultramarathons, that's what everyone's telling you to do, is drink, 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 drink. And they have some pretty ridiculous guidelines to go with it. So, lactic acid and blood lactate being a real problem in exercise comes from the same sort of thing. It's been in popular literature for so long that people aren't interested in listening to the, I almost said alternate view, but it's not an alternate view. It's lactic acid does not cause the end of exercise. It's an important part of our energy metabolism.
Well, Lindsey, let's talk about it and let's really sort of make it basic so that I can understand, because I obviously don't have a scientific background. What causes it? I mean, is it just one of the byproducts of exercising, and is it something we should worry about or try and avoid causing? I mean, what's the story?
Yeah, so look, to keep it extremely basic so that everybody understands it, it's a byproduct of energy metabolism. So when your body is busy breaking down chemical bonds inside the muscle that provides the chemical energy for the body to do mechanical work, lactate is a byproduct of that system, but it is shuttled away in the blood very quickly. So almost as soon as it's produced, it shifts into the blood, and then it's carried off to the liver where it's processed.
One of the things you hear often where runners will run a marathon or they'll run an ultra marathon, and they talk about their legs being really stiff, or if they've done a long training run, their legs are really stiff the next day, and they talk about, oh, that's lactic acid that's causing it. You need to go and run to get that lactic acid flushed out of your system. I'm taking it by what you're saying, that's not true.
Yeah, look, that part, in fact, Brad, that part is so not true that I know that it still exists in the literature, but I wasn't even thinking about that when I was formulating my answer, because that one should have been put to bed so long ago. It's not in, and never mind not being lactic acid, it's not any other impurity or byproduct of energy metabolism. That's actually physical tearing of the muscle from overexertion, and that pain is the inflammation that is caused by the little products that the body produces to come and repair those tears. So no, lactic acid absolutely got nothing to do with that. And I would you know, if you test your blood lactate after doing very, very intense exercise, even numbers of 17 or 19 millimoles per 100 milliliters of blood, even very high values like that, within 5 to 7 minutes of exercise will start to just steadily decrease. And, you know, within an hour, hour and a half of exercise, you should be back down to values of 0.9 or 1.2 millimoles. To have any remnants of lactic acid in the muscle the next day is just, it's not possible.
Then the other one is the role of lactic acid in cramping. There's a lot of people that swear that it's caused by a buildup of lactic acid once again in the muscles.
So, look, that one, lactic acid per se, probably not. But certainly other byproducts of energy metabolism which do cause the acidity or pH of the muscles to drop and for acidosis to take place in the muscles could well be involved in the interference of muscle function. So that one, while it's highly unlikely that it's lactic acid that's involved in that particular mechanism, certainly some hydrogen ions could well be playing a role in that process. But yeah, I mean, lactic acid's actual role in the exercise is still not properly understood. But at least we've gotten to the point where we know that it definitely provides some of the chemical energy that we need to produce the mechanical energy of movement.
Fantastic. Lindsey, as always, great to catch up. Don't forget, if you like some help with your training, all you need to do is head over to coachparry.com/join. We have got a very, very interactive online community. You can get access to all of our training programs. There's over 60 on the platform at the moment, plus all our strength and conditioning, warm-up, strength training, stretching, all of that sort of stuff. And it's all available through our very easy-to-use iOS and Android app. So go check that out, coachparry.com/join. And don't forget as well to let us know what your training for and what you need help for. All you need to do is use the hashtag BiogenJourney, and we could be picking you up off the social medias and making you a winner. You'll win access to the Coach Parry online training platform. Make sure you use that hashtag, okay? It's hashtag BiogenJourney, and you can check out some of the other cool stories that have been shared on social media as well. Lindsey, as always, thanks for your time. We look forward to catching up next week.
See you then, Brad.